Hi, Charu. Thanks for taking the time to discuss the new reporting dashboard that is available in the Office 365 Security and Compliance Center. I see a lot of reports in this dashboard. I was hoping you could provide me with some more details on these reports. For example, these two DLP reports. What can I do with these?
Thanks, Debraj. I'm happy to go over the reports dashboard with you. Here on the screen, you see the new reports dashboard in the Office 365 Security and Compliance Center. You asked about the DLP reports, so let's start from there. So here you see the DLP policy matches report. This report shows you one or more instances where DLP policies were matched. It tells you what policies and rules were triggered in the organization, which user was responsible for the policy breach, the sensitive information details around the breach, as well as the severity of the policy breach. This is a tool that can help you manage and track any policy violations over time. Most of the time, these violations are not malicious, so this visibility enables organizations to educate their users on best practices. In the event that there is malicious intent, admins have the visibility into the problem and can take steps to immediately resolve the situation. Additionally, as you can see in the UI here, we can also break down this report by services and policies or the actions that were taken.
Wow, that is very powerful. So this one report enables you to better understand, manage, and have visibility into the DLP policies that impact your users. Also, you can make real-time decisions and take action if you see any type of breach in the policies. How about the DLP false positive override report? How does this help?
This report helps admins understand what happened during the course of a policy violation. It gives our administrators a view into whether users chose to override a policy violation or reported it as a false positive. This, in turn, helps you determine the effectiveness of the policies and then tweak them as required.
Wow, this is great stuff. So as you know, I'm the PMM for Office ATP, so I definitely want to spend some time learning about these ATP reports. Looks like we have one for ATP file types and one for ATP file disposition. Can we walk through both these reports?
Sure. The Advanced Threat Protection File Types report gives information on what file types carried advanced threats and were stopped by Office 365 Advanced Threat Protection. Over time, this gives you an indication of which file types were most prevalent in bringing advanced threats into your environment.
Nice. How about the ATP message disposition graph? This looks like it lets the user know how ATP resolved an instance for an advanced threat. Also, could you show us a little bit more about the filtering function within each of these graphs?
Here we're looking at the Advanced Threat Protection Message Disposition report. This report shows you what actions ATP took with malicious content. This in turn gives admins insights to update their ATP policies if required in their organization. Let me show you some of our filtering options that we have here. As you can see here, there's multiple different file types that have been detected and that are being reported here. And you have the capability to filter out one or more of these. So let me show you an example. You can also choose to change the date range of the data that you want to see in this report. Once I do that and I click Apply, as you can see, the data that was being represented and presented to you has changed as well. So this gives more granular filtering and navigation options for the administrators to get the data that they're looking for.
Cool. Wow, that's great. It seems like I can also now look at the number of malware detections and top malware types that impact my tenant. Is that correct?
That's correct. Along with detecting malware, we also give you visibility into whether the malware was picked up on inbound or outbound data, and also the users that it was associated with. So we essentially provide you additional levels of granularity to detect the problems. Similarly, in the malware top malware type report, we break down the different types of malware that impacted the tenant and what their impact was.
This is awesome. It looks like these new reports are really going to add a great deal of visibility and control for our DLP and ATP users. I see there are some other reports also available in the dashboard, which cover spoof detection, spam detections, top email senders and recipients, and the overall number of emails sent and received in the tenant. All of these reports combined can really help admins stay informed and allow them to engage with their users.
Let me spend a minute on what else admins can do with these reports. From the reports in Security and Compliance Center, admins can choose to create schedules, as you can see here, which will allow them to receive reports directly into their inbox so they can stay on top of critical information for their organization. We now provide the option for admins either create one-click quick schedules or customize the information they want to receive by narrowing their schedule definitions using the customize schedule option. Additionally, admins can also request a custom report to be sent to their inbox by using the Request a Report option as seen here. Here again, they can either choose a broadly scoped report or narrow it down using available filter options. In both these cases, once a report is generated, a notification is sent to the recipients. In addition to this, we also have the Manage Schedules and the Manage Downloads dashboards in the Security and Compliance Center. Using these dashboards, you can manage the schedules that have been created for the tenant, for the reports, and also download reports that have been generated for you as requested.
All right, thanks a lot, Charu. This was really helpful. These reporting capabilities are great, and the UI and dashboard look awesome. I'm really excited for our users to be able to test out these new dashboards and be able to use them to their maximum capabilities.
Thank you, Debraj. It was my pleasure.